Hello viewers, welcome to Lemo TV, a station where you watch and learn. My name is Philaris Rich. Today I'm going to take you through English from 2, lesson 10. Our topic will be on grammar and we're going to look at the subtopic types of sentences and clauses. Welcome. Our lesson goal, we expect you as a learner to be able to define a sentence as well as define a clause and the name and name the different types of sentences. So we'll begin with defining what a sentence is, and you can say a sentence is a grammatically correct series of words which normally have the subject and the predicate. Any sentence must have a subject and a predicate. A sentence normally begins with a capital letter and ends in a full stop. A sentence should begin with a capital letter as well as end in a full stop. You can say a sentence is a group of words beginning with a capital letter and ending with a full stop. Exclamation or question mark in written language containing a main verb. If you look at the following, can you identify it as a sentence? The young boy walked to the shop. Yes, it's a sentence. It has the subject as well as the predicate. The subject is the young boy. And the predicate is walked to the shop. Walked is our main verb in the sentence. It's our predicate. We can also look at the definition of a clause, and you can say the following. A clause is a part of a sentence with a verb. A clause is a part of a sentence with a verb. However, it doesn't have to start with a capital letter or end with a full stop. Example, if you look at the following, can you relate it whether it's a clause or not? We're going to the shops. Is it a clause or not? Yes, it's a clause. So, can we look? We're going to learn how to embed clauses into sentences to make more interesting sentences. We're going to embed clauses to sentences. For example, the small girl walked the teacher. The small girl who was eating mildly apple walked towards the teacher. Another sentence, the teacher stood in the hall. So we're changing them to sentences that we are going to embed the clauses into sentences. So we have a clause like this, head teacher stood in the wall. So to make it, to embed into a sentence, we're going to read it as the head teacher who was hovering on a broomstick stood in the wall. We can look at examples of clauses and sentences. The woman ate her dinner quickly. I cannot move because my back hurts. Who was running really quickly? Jessie could swim really quickly, which was really smelly. You can look at the different types of sentences. We have sentences like the interrogatives. From the word interrogate, you can say it's a type of sentences which do ask questions. We look at the next type of sentences, which are the affirmative. From the word affirm, these are type of sentences which show positivity. They are always called the positive statement and they normally mean a yes. Next, we're going to look at the negative sentences. These are type of sentences which normally show negation or they usually mean a no. Having looked at the type of sentences and clauses, I hope you'll be able to do the following assignment. The following sentences are negative. Can you try to rewrite them to make them affirmative or the positive? The question like, I have little money. Okol seldom scores a goal. There is no food in the house. And lastly, nobody here knows the answer. For much more on clauses and sentences, you can refer them to Excelling in English Students Book 2, second edition, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can also contact us on our SMS line as posted, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter at Elimu TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson. Till next time.